How are you? Good, good. Welcome. Welcome to WDNA, to the WDNA Jazz Gallery. My name is Sarah Cruz. I manage membership here at WDNA. How many of you, it's your first time here? Yeah, awesome. Welcome. Members? Yeah, thank you. So WDNA is community public radio. That means we're listener supported, we're community supported, and we try to do more than just play music on the radio, which is cool, and we try to do a good job of that. But we also try to bring you really special concerts like Jazz Encounters that have both an incredible performance element from pros and amazing talent, and then that's fused with music education. So these are all the things we're trying to do. We're trying to bring you great music, live performance, and education for everybody who wants to learn and grow. And so that's all done with listener and community support. And so I also wanted to send a reminder, since this is part of my job here at the station, this is the season of giving, right? And so January 26th, I want you to mark your calendar. We're having a 2019 kickoff party here. And your invite to the party is very simple. Make a donation of any amount to WDNA this month of December before the year end. You come, we're gonna have live performance by an awesome local band, Shenzi. They're a bunch of UM grad students, graduates. They're gonna be performing. Some of your favorite DJs here at WDNA are gonna be doing some DJ sets in between. We'll have food, fun, gather. So thank you again for being here. I'm gonna toss it over to, any other information you wanna know about the station, WDNA.org, and we're on all the social media platforms. I'm gonna toss it over to this wonderful woman here, Nicole Yarling, who coordinates Jazz Encounters. Nicole?
Thank you, Sarah. Tonight's an adventure, as you can see. I want to talk about a few things, and I promise I'll try not to be too long-winded. But I'll get the sad things out of the way first. I'd like to dedicate tonight to a few people we lost. One person we lost in the community, Mike Orta. I don't know how many of you know him. He was an amazing, amazing musician and a dear friend. So I'll just leave it at that. I do feel especially honored that we were able to include him in the Jazz Encounters. And I've been posting, anybody read my Facebook page, I've been posting videos of the performance, and I'll continue to do that. That's why... Excuse me. When people say, here comes a crazy lady with a camera, I say, no. Things need to be documented. We need to, to document all of the historical things that happened here. That was one thing. Nancy Wilson, the passing of Nancy Wilson. I do feel, again, my brush with greatness with Nancy was, we were managed by the same person, John Levy. And so they did a tribute to him at the Beacon Theater in New York. And so it was hilarious. I'll tell you, this is not a funny story. It is funny to me anyway. I went out and I did my thing. I opened the show. And I thought I did a pretty good job. Buster Williams told me I did a good job. And then I went back. And then Nancy walked out on the stage and never opened her mouth. She walked out on the stage and got a standing ovation. So that just put me right back in my place. But I did take a picture. Our dressing rooms were next door to each other, and I have this picture of my name right next to hers. So that's my brush with greatness. She really was a wonderful person. And so I feel honored, to share the space with her and have her in my life in one way, shape, or the other. And then I wanted to mention that Frank woke me up the other morning, ding, with a text. From reminding me that it was not only Joel Williams' birthday, but Frank Sinatra, born on the same day, and Bob Dorough, Schoolhouse Rock. So there's a lot to be grateful for, but this is something I have to talk about. The last couple of months, Maggie mentioned that, the funding was running out for the Jazz Encounters, and I started to get sad and very nervous. So she said it one month, and then she said it the next month. And I was like, okay, oh, God, what am I going to do? So I said to her, Maggie, look, I don't have a lot of money, but I'll kind of chip in what we have, blah, blah, blah. So she said, nothing. I sent her an email. It's like, what's going on? Crickets, absolutely nothing at all. Then she emailed me and said, what's your EIN number? Well, scratch my head. I'm like, and then she emailed me back and said, oh, never mind. So it's not making it very cryptic, right? So I went to Atlanta to a conference, and I was there, and she called me up and said, hey, what are you doing Monday? I said, well, I'm teaching, but if there's a gig, I'll make myself available. And she was kind enough to tell me that she nominated the JECC for a Knight Foundation grant for $10,000. And I'm doing this because it means so much to me. That WDNA has been an amazing supporter of not only me, but the community. And so, wait, I'm not quite done. Wait. You've been my friend for a lot of years, and you've always been super 40? Supportive. 40? At least. Well, I was only, that would make me negative, no. And I can't thank you enough. I know these are, they pale in comparison to what, I wish I could buy you a yacht or something. But Maggie,
I wish.
I'm trying to play the lottery. I keep saying I'm going to buy it. But from myself, from the JECC, from the entire community, those guys back there in the room said the same thing. This venue is amazing because people come, and it's a dedicated audience that comes to hear music. Not in a bar with tinkling glasses, not someone saying how many people you can bring in a club, not, it's really set up for listening. And I can't thank you enough. Please come get these.
Let's get it over with. We don't even have to tell people to turn off their phones.
No. God, what could I sing? Maybe later on. These guys are, I know you're going to enjoy this. David is an amazing composer and saxophone player, and each and every one of these guys are amazing in their own right. So I'll stop now. Thank you guys. Happy holidays. Maybe I'll sing something later.
Breaking down spills. We got the beginning of Reptile right in. You want me to count you in or you want to just start? Count you in the very beginning?
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you.
Derek Fairholm on keys. Pete Brewer on bass clarinet, flute, and alto sax. Eddie Mena, alto flute, Chelsea Gilday, clarinet. Tom Lippincott, guitars. Rodolfo Zuniga. Thank you to the godmother of jazz, my godmother in jazz, Maggie, thanks for having me. Sarah, thanks for all your help. I'll let you ruin my credit. Whatever you need, doesn't matter. I'm missing somebody. Oh, Alex, thank you for the great sound. Thank you so much. I'd be remiss if I didn't do something for my grandparents or my grandfather. And also, I'd like to do something for the late Mike Warda. And today, we lost Nancy Wilson as well. We're gonna end the show with a song of mine called Eulogy.
Thank you. hold hands.
I didn't write any of it.
You didn't write any of it.
All Tom.
Man, I know it's
stock charts.
A bit too advanced for maybe not.
These are all Hal Leonard charts.
Yeah, right. No, but it would be great. This would be a great learning tool for the kids to hear you guys play and explain stuff and back and forth. So I'm thinking like a round table.
Okay. What we do is switch the instruments, and that's how we come up with the orchestration.
You're amazing. You really, truly are amazing. So thank you guys for this evening.
You got to go
see,
ahead.
See, now you understand why we need to do this. Yes.
You
got to
go.
You're not going to hear this.
G, right?
G, yeah. And I'll just steal the mic.
You want this one?
I just sing in the room.
This one clips on your ear.
Duh. Like whoa. So what? No. Okay, no, God, no. There's a lot of reverb on this thing. Oh, it disappeared, okay. And we all have lots to be grateful for this year. So, give me something. Chestnuts roasting on. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows some turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. Lippincott. Happy holidays, though.